there is power in stability. If there is no stability, there is turmoil. If there is turmoil, there's no peace. Let's talk about that. Hi, everyone. Welcome to Manna for Thought. The Webster Dictionary defines stability as the quality, state, or degree of being stable, such as the strength to stand or endure. In the Greek Strong's Concordance, it's stergmos, meaning a setting firmly, firmness, or to be steadfast. Paul in 1 Corinthians 15 verse 58 said, "Therefore, my beloved brethren, be ye steadfast, unmovable, always abounding in the work of the Lord. For as much as ye know that your labor is not in vain in the Lord." To be steadfast and unmovable is to be spiritually and mentally grounded. When you're grounded, you're in complete control of your mental and emotional self and not easily influenced by other ideas or individuals. Mental stability brings about a patient mind, which promotes emotional equilibrium. Emotion is a natural instinct, state of mind deriving from one's circumstances, mood, or relationships with others. And equilibrium is defined as a state of balance or a stable situation where opposing forces cancel each other out. So it is vital for your emotional equilibrium that you counterbalance anger, fear, and guilt with optimism, hope, and joy. So we are counteracting negativity with positivity. Remember, God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. Let's break down some of the key words in the scripture. First, Paul tells us to be steadfast. To be steadfast means to be firm in something, not to lose sight of who you are and your faith in God. A steadfast person is resilient, able to rebound after difficult times, knows who they are and what they believe, and cannot be carried away with every wind. Then Paul tells us to be unmovable, which is quite similar to being steadfast, to be unshaken. When the winds of life is upon us, we can stand firm because we've built our house upon the rock and not upon the sand. This means not to allow anyone or anything to move you from your clear direction, walking in God's will. Like a tree planted by the water, repeat after me, I shall not be moved. Finally, the word abounding in this text means to overflow, indicating abundance or surplus to go beyond expected measures. So for us, if we are to continue being steadfast and unmovable, achieving emotional equilibrium, we need to always be drinking from the fountain so we do not thirst. John 4 verse 14, Jesus said, "But whosoever drinketh of the water that I shall give unto him shall never thirst, but the water that I shall give him shall be in him a well of water springing up into everlasting life." Here Jesus references the Holy Ghost that he promised. In John 14 verse 26, he said, "But the Comforter, which is the Holy Ghost, whom the Father will send in my name, he shall teach you all things and bring all things to your remembrance." Through his Holy Ghost, you can bring peace into any situation. You will receive the necessary strength and patience to overcome any attack of the enemy. Paul encourages us that no matter what, We should not waver from our faith or give up on the promises that God has made to us. Even in times of trouble, sickness, family troubles, money issues, problems with spouse or children, which will happen or come in some way, shape, or form in each of our lives. Paul is telling you and I to hang in there because God knows the plan he has for us. God wants us to have peace. He said, "Peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid." Trust in the Lord. He is your strength, and he can bring you out of any situation that may come in your life. I'm Allison Cornelius, and thank you for joining me on Manna for Thought.